And welcome back to our channel Fintu, and you're watching Friday First Cut series. I am Nidhi Manchanda, certified financial planner and head of training, research and development at Fintu. Are you looking forward to invest into real estate but are facing a challenge of high ticket size? Then REITs are something which you should definitely explore. So stay tuned in today's video as we'll be discussing about REITs in detail. So let's start by understanding what exactly are REITs. REITs, that is Real Estate Investment Trust, these are basically created by a sponsor who transfers the ownership of assets to a trust in exchange of the units. It might sound complicated, but it is simple if we understand that it is very similar to how mutual fund works. So what happens in a mutual fund is that investors invest money. For example, someone has invested 500 rupees, someone has invested 1,000, 10,000, 1 lakh or more. And once this entire money is pooled, then a fund manager invests this money into the stock market. Let's say if you are taking an example of equity mutual fund. So this money is invested into a stock market and whatever returns are generated are then passed on to the investors. So in a REIT also similar thing happens. So what happens is all these small retail investors invest their money, let's say starting from 10,000, 15,000, somebody would invest 1 lakh, and once this pool of money is there, then the REIT managers would utilize this money to invest into the real estate market. So basically they'll be investing this money by buying properties. So that is what happens in a REIT. So as a small retail investor, we might not be able to invest into real estate as the investment is huge in lakhs and crores of rupees. But by using REITs, you can have an exposure to real estate in as low as 10 to 15,000 rupees. So definitely if someone is looking out to invest into real estate, REITs could be one option, especially for small investors. Please note here that REITs are different from real estate mutual funds. When we talk about real estate mutual funds, they invest into the shares of a real estate company. Whereas in REITs, the investment is made in the property itself. So there is a difference between the two. Now that you know what exactly are REITs, please note that REITs are relatively new in India. In US, REITs were introduced in the year 1960. However, in India, this concept is relatively new and SEBI launched this in the year 2014. But the first REIT which actually got listed and introduced in India was in the year 2019. The first REIT introduced in India was Embassy, which was introduced after doing multiple amendments in the REIT Acts by the SEBI. Now let us see what are the current regulations. Number one, SEBI regulations require REITs to pay out 90% of the distributable cash flows to unit holders in the form of dividends. Second important thing, REITs must have at least 80% of their assets to be completed and income generating. The remaining 20% can be invested in under construction properties as well. The third important point is that sponsor is obligated to hold 15% units of the REITs. And fourth one is it has to be mandatorily listed on the stock exchange. And once it is listed, they can raise debt and equity in the capital market to acquire new assets and grow. Coming to some of the advantages of REITs, the first one is higher liquidity. So definitely if you are investing into REITs, the liquidity will be higher compared to your physical investment into a physical real estate. Second important advantage is diversification. If you are investing into any real estate property directly, you would be investing only in one property in one particular location. But if you are investing into a REIT, you will get an exposure to multiple locations. So definitely a higher diversification. The third point is that it is affordable. So yes, you can invest into REITs with as low as 10 to 15,000. And the fourth important advantage is it is safe because it is regulated by SEBI. Otherwise, the real estate industry is quite unorganized. Now moving on to see the REITs outlook in India. Well, if you talk about REITs, it's one of the ways to get exposure into real estate without the burden of heavy investments. But if you look at India, it has seen a sluggish start when it comes to REITs, but it is no different as compared to other countries. So in US also, the first REIT was launched in the year 1960, but it took several decades for this investment avenue to be accepted by the investors. We suggest you to take an advice from a financial advisor who can guide you about investments into REITs as per your own risk profile, your goal and investment tenure. Currently in India, there are three REITs. So first one is Embassy REIT, which was the first launch. Second is Mindspace REIT, and the third one is Brookfield India REIT. Now, when it comes to investing into REITs, you need to see few factors before you select which one you should be investing into. And what are these factors basically? The first thing that you need to check is weighted average lease expiry, and this should be higher the better. The second one is distribution yield. Again, this should be higher the better. Loan to value ratio, this is also one of the important aspects that you need to check, and here lower will be the better option. The another thing that you need to check is net distributable cash flow, higher occupancy rate, and diversified portfolio across the locations and sector. Now coming to how you can invest into REITs. Well, investing in REITs is quite simple. What you need to do is just you need to have a demat account and a trading account, and just like how you invest into shares, similar way you can invest into REITs also, as these are listed on the stock exchange BSE and NSE. I hope you got a better clarity on REITs now, and feel free to get in touch with our finance experts to get personalized recommendation for you on REITs. And for more such videos, do subscribe to our channel.